conduct. It's a technique. It's a technique of taking care of a newborn babies. Mainly the mothers are taking care of the babies like that, occasionally with their fathers also. Ma, can you see the slide clearly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. In history of gangroo madakar, this actually previously, that is olden days, the gangroo madakar is not this much prominent, and there is no usage of that. Even they don't know about that. It was developed in Bogota, Colombia in the year of 1979 by Dr. Ray and Martins. Because this actually in previous days, you all know, right? This they don't have a lot of nurseries. They don't have much facilities. It is overcrowded hospitals. Then low birth weight is also more because their nutritional status is very low. Mostly in developing countries, they don't have the much nutritional facilities, though the babies are in low birth weight. So that time they cannot taking care of the babies properly. So approximately the infant death was 70% at that time. 70% in the sense very high, right? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, actually, if low birth weight, birth of low birth weight is 100 babies in the sense, in that 70% babies will be died out. So that Drs. Ray and Martins find out this gangroo madakar. Nowadays, actually 20 million infants are born in low birth weight, but the death rate is very low. The survival rate is 80 to 90%. So how much the death rate will be? Only 10%, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. 70%, now only 10%. So, because of our technologies as well as the practice of gangroo mother care. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then, complications of low birth weight infants. What are the complications we can expect in low birth weight infants? Can anyone say? No problem. Whatever this, that may be a wrong thing also, no problem. You have to participate, that's all. Already you may see the babies with low birth weight, right? No?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, what are the complications they may have? What we can expect? What complication they may develop? Because of low birth weight. See, the baby is very tiny, right? Sorry? One answer came now. You are right only, tell me.
Ma'am, respiratory problems.
Sorry? Not able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you hear?
Ma'am,
can you hear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, my voice is clear, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. Okay then. Okay. What are the complications of low birth weight babies? Okay, it's okay. This infections. Actually, the babies. Why infections more more common to babies with low birth weight? Because. Anybody know? Okay. This actually, the immune system is not developed properly, right? This the baby is premature or low birth. So their immune system is not developed properly. So they are prone to more infections, mainly to the hospital acquired infections. Hospital acquired infection, what is the other name for hospital acquired infection?
Nosocomial infection.
Yeah, exactly. Very nice. This nosocomial infections, because the baby is because of low birth weight, the baby has to stay in the hospital for a long term. So they are acquiring the infections very fast because they don't have the immune system properly. They don't have the developed immune system. Then hypothermia. Why hypothermia? Because they don't have the adipose tissue, right? This adipose tissue in the sense they already low birth weight. They don't have the fatty tissues. So they cannot withstand to the environmental temperature. They will go for the hypothermia. Then respiratory problems. Respiratory problems, mainly these babies used to get pneumonia, then apnea. Why? In the in already you studied the growth and development of newborns, right? Have you studied?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
During birth, what is the how can we measure the lung development during birth? How can we? That's not in a normal procedure. Usually, for the low birth weight babies, they used to do. What enzyme they will measure after low birth weight or immature? That enzyme is called lecithin sphingomyelin. That enzyme that is in the lungs, if this ratio should be 2 to 2.5 in the sense, that will be normal. It's less than 2.5 in the sense, less than 2 in the sense, the baby will get pneumonia. Okay, there is a surfactant, that is the surfactant, it's in the lungs. It is increasing the surface pressure. If that is less in the sense, it will increasing the surface pressure. So the baby cannot breathe properly. It will lead to apnea. Can you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
what
ma'am.
Is, yeah, what is that enzyme? What is that enzyme I told? What is the surfactant I told? Lecithin sphingomyelin. Okay. So then early growth retardation. This baby is already premature, low birth weight. Their growth also not in proper. Then because of early growth retardation, they cannot have attaining their milestones properly. Then trouble feeding and gaining weight. If the feeding is in trouble, they cannot gain weight. That is normal, right? Why trouble feeding will be there to the babies? They are not able to suckle properly because when the baby is sucking, they babies have to create a vacuum. Okay, vacuum in the mouth so that only the baby can suck properly. Then only they can swallow. Here, these babies don't know to create a vacuum in the oral cavity. So the baby is not able to suck and swallow. So their weight gain is very less. Then infectious diseases, that's same. Infectious diseases, normally the babies will develop, that is enterocolitis because of the E. coli bacteria and all, they will develop enterocolitis. Usually, E. coli bacteria will be in everywhere, all the environment or wherever we are touching, there will be. But we are having immune against that. But these newborns, they don't have immune system development, no? So they will get it very easily. Development delay will be there. Death during infancy and childhood. Actually, during this, all the complications will be less if the babies are undergoing gangro mother care. If the babies are always staying with the mother in the skin to skin contact, in the sense, these all complications will be very minimized. The babies are survived as well as thrived. So survived in the sense they can live, but thrived in the sense they are prosper. In the sense, their development will be more. Can you understand? Yeah?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Indications, yes, ma'am. Of, okay. Indications of gangro mother care. That indications in the sense what? Indications means what?
Ma'am, yaarukkalam kudukkalam.
Yeah, correct. Exactly. This indication for which are all the babies we can give gangro mother care. For example, one baby is very not able to breathe. The baby is having apnea, pneumonia, cyanosis, everything is there. Can we give gangro mother care to that baby? Can we? No. Why? In the sense, that is a medical emergency. If the babies are clinically stable in the sense only, we can give gangro mother care. If the babies are low birth weight, premature, even though the baby's apgar is, now what is the normal apgar? Apgar score already studied? No. Okay. This normal apgar is 10. If the apgar score is 7 to 10 in the sense, the baby is normal. So if the baby's apgar is 7 to 10 after delivery in the sense, so the baby after immediately after dried the baby, we should transfer the baby to skin contact. Otherwise, gangro mother care to the mother. If the baby is not having apgar properly, the baby is developing cyanosis as well as apnea, in the sense we should transfer the baby to the neonatal ICU. The baby should be kept in incubator care. Okay. Then this indications is premature or low birth weight babies in neonatal care. Then good apgar with no clinical problems. Routine care of newborns weighing 2000 grams. The baby is 2000 grams, 2 kg or less, in the sense the baby is normal, clinically normal in the sense we can give. Low birth weight and full term babies. Then full term babies are infants who are separated from their mother due to some medical reasons. If the mother is not feeling well, the mother is sick after delivery, in the sense the family members, especially the father, can give gangrene mother care. Then we establish breastfeeding and a good milk supply. This the mother is having good milk supply if the baby is under the gangrene mother care, then clinically stable infants. Already we saw that, right? If you are not understanding, in the sense, you just stop me and ask, okay? Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, are you lying, right? Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, components of gangrene mother care. Components in the sense, what are all the things are there in gangrene mother care? That is components or elements. We can say it as a elements also. That's gangrene position. Gangrene position is skin to skin contact. That should be prolonged, continuous skin to skin contact with the mother. Next is gangrene nutrition. Nutrition, what is the baby's nutrition? Breastfeeding, right? That should be frequent as well as exclusive breastfeeding. What is the meaning of exclusive breastfeeding?
Only breastfeeding, ma'am.
Yeah, correct.
Up to 6 months.
Yes, till 6 months, the baby should be fed only with the breastfeeding, not anything else. In the sense, some cultures, they used to give that one, the sugar, water and all, right? Immediately after birth. That should be discouraged because the baby cannot digest. That is very heavy food to the baby. The baby cannot digest that. So only exclusive breastfeeding should be given to the babies, because their gut is also not improved for the digestive enzymes and all. So it should be. Then gangrene support. Gangrene support in the sense love and affection to the mother as well as to the baby. The love and affection to the mother is more important in gangrene mother care. Without family support, the mother can give very calm and quiet environmental gangrene mother care. Can? No, right? They always, the mother needs family support during, especially during these crisis periods. In that, then gangrene discharge. This gangrene discharge, in the sense, after this, when after going to home also, the mother has to continue the gangrene care, because the discharge will be very early. If the mother is giving gangrene mother care, in the sense, the discharge time is very early, hospital stay is very less to that children. Okay, benefits of gangrene mother care. Actually, this in this element, skin to skin contact is main. That's major role. Then love, warmth, and breastfeeding. Everything will be comes as a benefits as well as components. What are all the benefits the mother, baby, as well as the family members can get? Okay, benefits are gangrene mother care. Mothers. After delivery, you may see the mothers, right? This how their psychological status will be. How? Anybody? You can talk, no problem.
Ma'am, please.
Sorry?
Ma'am, please repeat the question, ma'am.
Actually, after delivery, how the mother feel? What is the cycle of the mother? It's a newborn, right? That is a very tiny baby. As well as the baby is in very low birth weight, premature. How the mother will feel? I'm not hearing any responses.
The mother will be feeling happy.
The mother will feel happy after this.
No, ma'am.
No, right. The baby, that mother will feel very stressed because how to handle the baby. She don't know how to handle the baby. Even that may be the primi gravida in the sense. That means the first baby in the sense. The mother will feel very distressed, depressed, stressed, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now the baby is always... Sorry? Can you? Yeah, some answers are coming. Na? No problem if that's wrong also. You are students only. No, I am here to clarify your doubts only. Okay. See, this the mother will be very psychologically very distressed. So if we are giving gangrene care in the sense, the mother will be getting confidence. Why? She is always having the baby with her. Okay, she is having the confidence. Yes, my baby is with me. So she is getting more confidence to take care of the baby. So the baby, she is also taking very active part in the role of the infant's care. Then she is feeling less stressed, no? So breastfeeding is promoted. How? Because this oxytocin and prolactin, that are the both enzymes, it will be giving more let down reflex. Let down reflex in the sense milk producing reflex. So that during less stress time, the let down reflex will be more. So the mother is getting more breastfeeding. So breast milk will be more. So the baby can take easily, get more breast milk. Then less neglect and abandonment. Nowadays, we are seeing many places that the child has abandoned. The child has neglected like that. Now, after the gangruka, the mother is having much bonding toward the kids. So because she is always with the child, she is taking every small, tiny movements from the kid, that newborn. So she is not having, our place, it won't happen. But even though she is not having the tendency to neglect or abandon the kid, then fight postpartum depression. After delivery, the mothers are having fully stressed by taking care of the kid. They won't get proper sleep. Then their daily routine is changed. That is totally changed. Their world is upside down. So the mother used to get postpartum depression. But in gangrene care, the mother will be very calm. She is less stressed. The baby is with her. A lot of breastfeeding is there. So she is getting away from postpartum depression. These are all the benefits of gangrene mother care to mothers. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. For fathers, what are all the benefits in the sense? The fathers, if the mother is, when, for example, when the mother is the whole day, that 12 hours, she is giving continuous gangrene care. She needs some rest. Otherwise, she has to go for washing and all. That means for personal hygiene also she has to know. So she some break she needs. So the father can take over the duty of that gangrene mother care. So this the father is also feeling satisfied and fulfilled. This I am also taking care of my baby. I can also taking care of my baby. So the father is also getting more confidence out of it. Then it improves bonding between fathers and infants, like the same like mothers. Then reduce violence towards children. This the father is also taking care of the child when from birth itself. So the father is the father don't have the tendency to have any violence toward children. Then for infants, what are all the benefits? Better adaptation to the environment. The infants are always with the chest of the mother. So the baby is feeling warmth always. So the baby is adapting to the outer environment, outer temperature, everything. Then infants can be kept warm and stable with gangrene mother care. Then healthy weight gain and infants grow faster. The babies are having very healthy weight gain because of the let down reflex, the mother is having more feeding. If the baby is not able to suck also, the mother can give expressed breast milk through tubings, mostly in Gangro Madhakar, tube feedings won't be there. But in Palade feedings, you may be seen or heard, right? That in our places and all, they will use that small Palade. Yes? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then better mental development. This baby is with fully, the baby is calmly sleeping. Then oxygenation is proper. The temperature, body temperature is normal. So better mental development will be there. Normally for low birth weight babies or premature babies, what will happen, you know, this after immediately after birth of the baby, they are very tiny. They are not matured enough. So the brain cells will be very tiny. They cannot handle the outer environment. So it will be burst and that small tiny vessels will be start to bleed. So the babies will start a mental problems. That means this brain developmental problems will be there. But these babies with Gangro Madhakar, they are having the better mental development than the incubator babies. Then serious infections is less common in infants because here the mother, the baby is always with the mother. So whatever this that means infections or whatever organisms will be there on the mother only will affect the baby. So it can be cured by the breastfeeding. That because all the immunities will be there. Breastfeeding is the well nutritious food to the babies, right? So outside environment or outside infection won't affect the baby. Then less apnea, improving the baby's breathing pattern and making the breathing more regular. The baby is not breathing this very difficulty breathing and all won't be there because the mother's breathing as well as the heart rate will be regulating and stimulating the baby's heart rate as well as breathing. Okay, understood? The mother's breathing will be normal. The mother's warmth, that means temperature will be normal. Her heart rate will be normal because the baby is in the chest. So the baby is hearing everything. The baby is feeling everything. So it is stimulating the baby to breathe normal. Okay. So the apnea level, the apnea, risk of apnea is very less to the babies. Then stabilizing the baby's heart rate. Then improving oxygen saturation levels. After this, in Gangro Madhakar, the baby's oxygen saturation level is increased because apnea won't be there. The baby is sleeping very peacefully. The baby is very calm. It's not have any stress. So oxygen level will be increased. So all the cells and tissues of the body is getting much oxygen. Then gaining in sleep time, experiencing more rapid weight gain, then decreasing crying. The baby is sleeping and being calm. Everything is okay. So the baby is not crying. Actually, in incubator, you know what will happen in the sense the baby is not getting this much warmth and all. It's the babies don't have in skin to skin contact also. The baby will become distressed. So the baby will get annoyed. So they are having much respiratory problems. Apnea will be there because they are not feeling settled there. So they are getting much, they want more oxygenation. So they are getting apneic episodes. But it's very less in Gangro Madhakar. Then having more successful breastfeeding episode because it's always it's access to the baby. No, the baby is in the chest of the mother, so it's easily accessible. So the baby can try to suck. Otherwise, the mother can express the feed and feed to the baby. Having an earlier hospital discharge. This is more necessary. This the baby with the Gangro Madhakar, they can continue. If the baby is very stable in the sense they can continue in the home itself after discharge. Then what is the benefit for health care providers? Because now, for example, only 5 or 6 beds will be that beds will be there in NICU, but 8 babies are in low birth weight. It will be a stress to the health care providers. Yes. Or no? Should we think, oh, that's not our problem. The bed is only 6, so 2 we cannot take care of. We should think like that. Can we? Can you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, should we think like that? Actually, this the bed is not available. So we should take, we should not take care of two other babies. Can we left like that? No, right? We should give the optimum care to the babies. Here, the mother is taking care of the baby in the postnatal ward itself. So there is no need of bed and all. So there is fewer staff is necessary and less equipment is necessary. So the healthcare providers also feeling happy and satisfied. Infants can be discharged home earlier. It is cheaper. There is no need of paying for incubator, no need of paying for all the machines, oxygens, this one, that one, and also it's very cheaper. Next is types of gangrene mother care. Two types are there: intermittent gangrene mother care and continuous gangrene mother care. Intermittent in the sense, occasionally we are giving something, then we are stopping that, then again giving something like that. Intermittent gangrene mother care, when in the sense, when the baby is admitted in NICU, the baby is having some clinical problems. So the mother cannot hold the baby always because some special treatment is necessary to the babies, right? So that time and all, the mother should go, whenever the mother is going to the NICU, that time the mother can give gangrene mother care. That may be an hour's time or maybe a 10 minutes time. Even though that is 10 minutes time, it will be a beneficial to the baby. Can you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Then continuous gangrene mother care, in the sense the mother provides gangrene mother care all the time, continuously. Whenever the mother is not able to give, the father can take care of the role, take over the role, and he will continue. Then next, after mother comes, mother will continue. So full time, that is a continuous mother care. Intermittent mother gangrene mother care should be given in the special care needed babies. Whenever the babies are admitted in the NICU, that babies need intermittent gangrene mother care. Whenever the mother is available or whenever the baby is free, that is in the sense, little time, 10 minutes or 1 hour time, the baby don't, no need of any treatment. This is mother can give. She has to go and sit in the NICU and she has to take care of the baby that time. That is intermittent. Continuous in the sense, the baby is stable, the Apgar is correct, the baby don't have any clinical symptoms or clinical complication, in the sense continuously the mother can give gangrene mother care for gaining the weight. The main thing is the baby's weight gain is more necessary as well as the feeding. The baby should take the feeding properly. That is. Okay, till now, any doubts?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Yeah, you understand, right?
No, ma'am.
You can understand,
yes, ma'am.
Right? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Thank you. When should gangrene mother care be started? When to start? Any idea? It's very new to you, but when to start? After, till now we saw this one, no? So,
ma'am, after birth, ma'am.
Yeah, correct. Exactly. Superb. This immediately after birth. After birth, the baby will be dried and examined and cord is cut. In the sense, we can hand over the baby to the mother for feeding as well as for skin-to-skin contact, gangrene mother care. Then, this many low birth weight infants can be given. This the baby is low birth weight even though the baby is stable. Low birth weight in the sense, when we can call that as a low birth weight?
Ma'am, the baby who have below 2.7 kg.
Below 2.5 kg, we can call it as a low birth weight. When we can call very low birth weight babies? That is 1,500 grams. Okay. That is 1.5 kg. The baby is less than 1,500 grams in the sense, we can call that as a very low birth weight baby. 1,500 to 1,700. Understood? So the normally less than 28 weeks of gestation, the baby is born less than 28 weeks of gestation in the sense, the baby will develop lot of complications. After 28 weeks in the sense, the minimal complications will be very minimal. So here the low birth weight babies also can be given gangrene mother care if they are clinically stable. Then normal infants also can be given, we can promoting gangrene mother care for promoting bonding as well as in improving their breastfeeding and preventing hypothermia. Then infants who are ill at birth should receive when they have recovered the clinical condition. After they have their clinical condition is stable, we can start give gangrene mother care. If the baby is in incubator or in NICU, after their clinical condition is stable, they are, till then they are in intermittent gangrene mother care, in the sense after they are stable, they can start the continuous gangrene mother care. Okay, we can start the continuous gangrene mother care. We can hand over the baby to the mother. Then immediately after birth, we should give the breastfeeding. We should encourage the mother to give feed immediately. What mothers need while starting gangrene mother care? What are all the things the mother need? Health and nutrition. Mother should be healthy first. Then her nutrition, the well-balanced diet. After, immediately after delivery, the mother will be weak. She need to supply to the baby also. So the nutrition will be proper. Then general hygiene should be proper to the mother. The mother has to take care of herself hygienically. Whenever she is taking care of the baby, she should wash the hands, and every time, every day she has to change the dress, everything. Support from family members. That's already we saw that. And comfortable clothing. Comfortable clothing is very necessary during this gangrene mother care. Facilities, equipment and supplies. Is it boring to you all?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
I can continue, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, this facilities, equipments, and supplies. This, what are all the facilities we need in the rooms of a mother's? If the mother is taking care of the baby the whole day. You just imagine this is a continuous gangrene mother care. What are all the facilities the mother need in the sense? The room should be equipped with comfortable beds. The mother always can sit in a chair and taking care of the baby. That's very difficult, right? So the mother should be in a comfortable bed or chairs with supportive pillows. Then semi-recumbent position for resting and sleeping. Semi-recumbent position in the sense 30 to 40 degree elevated, head elevated position. That is like Fowler's, right? Fowler's already, you may be practiced, no? For wheezing and respiratory problem patients.
Ma'am.
Yes?
Ma'am, hypothermia, ma'am, adhima affect agaranga.
What is that?
Ma'am, hypothermia, adhima adhima affect pandranga.
Actually, hypothermia, because the babies don't have subcutaneous fat, no? So, till in the womb, they are having in a very warmth environment. When they are coming out immediately, they are very skinny. They don't have fat at all. So they cannot go for, that is, they cannot cope up with the outside environment. So that the room should be very warm. This hypothermia, normally, their body growth is underdeveloped. So they cannot produce much heat. That body itself, they cannot produce much heat. As well as their body condition is also not adapting to the environment. So we have to fully cover the baby to preventing hypothermia, as well as skin to skin contact, in the sense whenever the mother's body is warm, the baby is hypothermic, in the sense less than 35 degrees centigrade, in the sense the mother's body will balancing with the baby's temperature. Whenever baby is getting hypothermia, the mother's body will be settled down, cooler, and it will be equalizing both. Can you understand? This is the advantage of gangrene mother care. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
They don't have the subcutaneous fat. So they are not adapting to the outside environment. Till them they are not used to that environment, right? So immediately they are coming and exposing to this environment. So they are getting hypothermic. They are not maintaining, they cannot maintaining to the outside environment. So that in the delivery rooms and all, when the deliveries happen, on the time of delivery, the room temperature should be 27 degrees centigrade. Okay. So, because of the baby should not get hypothermic. Understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, clear, or something more is more necessary? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then semi-recumbent position in the sense the baby's, the mother's bed should be in 30 to 40 degree elevated. Okay. So that only she can comfortably lie down, not lie down fully. This you can little elevated and taking care of the baby. Where we have seen in the first picture, no, that in the slide, first slide, like that. Okay. Then curtains should be there. Then a room should be 22 to 24 degrees centigrade. Now, usually our places and all, it won't be much cooler in summer, right? So this is the normal temperature, 22 to 24 degree. Then bathroom facility should be there with water, soap and towels, because of the mother has to take care of her hygiene also. And she's taking care of the baby. She has to wash her hands every time. Whenever she, after break, when she's taking care of the baby, she has to wash her hands. Then nutritious meals should be supplied to the mother. Then daily shower or washing is sufficient to maternal hygiene. Then strict hand washing. Nowadays, there is no need to say, nah? Everybody is following that because of this pandemic. Then discourage from smoking while providing gangroo mother care. Visitors also should be instructed. They should not be allowed to smoke. We should tell the visitors also, you should not. It's strict for the visitors too. During the hospital stay, that's okay. They won't smoke in the hospital, but in the home gangroo care also, the continuous gangroo care also, we should insist the visitors to stop smoking, because the baby's lung is immature. The baby is now only, the baby is starting to adapting to the new environment as well as starting to adapt to breathe properly. So that time the baby is getting much smoke in the skin, it will be a very big complication, leads to apnea. Clothing for the mother. The mother can wear whatever she is comfortable as well as warm to the environment. Then that mother's clothing should accommodate the baby also inside. Outside of the mother's clothing, the baby should not be placed inside, because skin to skin contact, mother's skin should touch the baby's skin like that. Okay. Then special garments or traditional one, if the traditional ones are too tight, we can go for the other garments. Otherwise, we can use the same garments itself. Some hospitals, they are having their policy of giving garments to the mothers who are, you know, taking care of gangroo mother care. So that can be replaced. And so whatever dresses it will be, it should be a friend open dress. The because the baby should be placed on the mother's chest. So the friend open dress should be required for the mother. That should be recommended. Then support binder. These are all the binders. By seeing itself, you know that, right? These are all the binders. This binders, it's having tail, no? This, can you understand? See, by seeing?
Yes, ma'am.
See, for example, this, if the mother is taking this binder, can you see my cursor moving? Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. This binder, in the sense, we should place the baby, then we should put the binder up, then it should be tied.
Yes.
What is that? Hello? Sorry? I'm not hearing you. Okay. See, this binder, so this tails, no, this tail should be tied with the mother for holding the baby, because it should be tied up with the mother, in the sense accidental falling won't be there, right? There's when the mother is taking this nap, or when the mother is sleeping also, she is giving gangroo mother care. So the there is a chance of falling of the baby, right? So if she is tying with her, as well as above that, she has to cover the baby with a blanket or with her dress. Understood, ma? It should be tied.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, the baby should be placed on the chest of the baby. As that previously, the baby, this mother's chest will be exposed. Then the baby should be placed on that. Then this binder should be applied. Then it should be tied with the mother's armpits. Then above that, blankets or mother's clothing should be covered. All the binders are like that. This also, this same like. Okay, yeah. Is it okay, right?
Yes,
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that's yes, one. Is, yeah, this is explaining. This is the only special item needed for Gangro Madaka. Other everything is ordinary. This is the only thing that's binder is necessary for holding the baby safely close to their chest. Then this knot is tucked under the mother's armpit. Then this according to the mother's choice, we can, these are all the, actually these are all the binders. According to mother's choice, you can choose whatever is comfortable to her. She can choose that one. Then this every day, this pouch also has to be replaced every day. Then actually, have you seen now also this, not for gangro curve, when we are going outside also, very small babies, that means till infancy or yeah, 2 years, till 2 years, we are having one bag. Have you seen that? Front side, we can hanging the baby. Have you seen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, this for when we are walking outside and all this, we can hold the baby in the bag itself. The strap will be like our bags. Okay, we will put our bags front back side. We are putting the baby front side like that. We can put the bags and tie it up off so the baby won't fall like that. Okay, so like the same procedure here also, they will be tied up with the armpit with the mother and whatever is necessary, whatever is comfortable. This is like a blouse. Okay. This so this one, after putting the baby inside, the mother has to cover with that, then she should tie it. Then clothing for the baby. If the baby is 22 to 24 degrees centigrade, the baby should be naked. Only diaper and warm hat and woolen socks or mittens should be wear. The baby drops below 22 degrees in the sense, baby should be wear the sleeveless dress. But the front will be open, because front will be open only the skin to skin contact is possible. Okay. The mother cover herself and the baby with the usual dress. Already we told, no? This, with her usual dress or with other blankets. They need much warm in the sense, they need much more blankets. The gangro position is also called skin to skin contact. If it's open in the front in the sense, here it's very better. If the baby is in normal temperature, 22 to 24 in the sense, the baby, there is no need of wearing any dresses, only nappy. Here, the baby is less than 22 in the sense, the baby has to wear the sleeveless dress with the front open. Now, then nappy, socks and this cap. Other equipments, thermometer should be there. Because actually the thermometer should be down till 35 degrees centigrade also, because the babies are having very hypothermic, no? So each and every small things also should be calculated. So suitable thermometer should be there for the low birth weight babies. Then scales, that scales interval should be 10 gram intervals, because the babies are gaining weight 10 to 20 grams only, very gradually they will gaining their weight. So it has to be measured. Then totally, that is a maximum weight gain in the sense 112 to 200 grams per day only. No, sorry, per week. So it should be very cautiously measured, this scale. So the scale interval should be 10 grams. Then basic resuscitation equipments also, because the babies are fully not fully matured, not fully developed. So there is some complication. There is a chance of some complication. So when the mother is staying in the hospital, basic resuscitation equipment should be available always, as well as oxygen. That is very mandatory thing. The baby can go for apneic whatever time it may be. So we have to expect the worst. So oxygen should be available always. Then drugs should be this in the cupboard itself. That's in the, according to the hospital policies, they used to have drugs. We won't prescribe any drugs. Then procedure of gangro mother care. The baby should be placed in upright position between the mother's breast. Already we discussed about that. The baby's head should be placed to your side. What will happen? The baby's head will be on like that, in the sense the nose will be pressed, no? So the baby cannot breathe properly. So the head should be turned to one side and the chest should be with mother's chest, so that only the baby can see the mother also. Okay, understood, ma? So the nose will be free to breathe. Yes, the baby can see the mother also. So the head should be tilted to one side. Okay. The baby's tummy should be placed on mother's upper abdomen. The baby's arm and leg should be folded. This, when the baby is in the womb, the arm and leg will be folded so the baby can preserve its warmth. After coming outside also, we are mummifying the baby, no? Why we are mummifying the baby? Oh, protecting the heat, protecting the warmth. Okay, so this for preventing the heat loss, we are mummifying the baby immediately after birth. Like the same thing here, the arms and legs should be folded. So when arms and leg will be folded, the warmth will be conserving into the baby. The sling or a binder should be support the baby's bottom. The baby should not go down from mother's chest. No, so the sling or baby's this sling should be tied with the mother by supporting the bottom of the baby. Understood, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then how to hold the baby? This is a picture. See, they are just standing, but they have to take a comfortable position first. That means they should lie down in a semi-recumbent. This supported their bottom. That is bottom of the baby supported. The baby is covered with the hat. The father is also taking care of. He has covered with his clothing. Okay. Then how can gangroo mother can save money? How can all the parents can afford to incubate? Is it possible?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Correct. This all the parents now for 1 day incubator itself, that will be so costly. But for this premature babies, in the sense, but they have to stay in the hospital for a long time, for month, for weeks or months, or sometimes till 6 months, even like that. So all the parents cannot afford to that much money. So this the gangroo mother, for the critically ill children, that is mandatory. But the baby is having low birth weight, but they are clinically stable, in the sense, why can't we take care of, right? Nah? So the mother can take care of, so they can save money. Breastfeeding saves the cost of buying formula. This, nowadays, the formulas and all very costly. So you can most of the families cannot afford to that. So the now the mother is mother's feeding is enough to the baby, because already we saw that, a letdown reflex will be more, so their mother is producing much milk, so they can feed the baby directly or express the milk and giving feeding to the baby. So buying formula is not a necessary thing. Then fewer nurses are necessary, as the mother provide most of the care to her infant. The mother is taking care of the baby. There is no need of other staffs there. Some attenders, for little observation is necessary. So much of the timings, the mother will take care of the baby. Then less hospital equipments are required, such as incubators. So some hospitals, 1 or 2 incubators will be there. So much crowded low birth weight babies means much babies will be neglected. So there is no need of there in gangroo mother care. Then with less infections, in special care and intensive care units itself, the baby will be getting infections sometimes. Here it can be avoided, as well as money is also saved. Small infants can be discharged home sooner. They can go to home very sooner. Then discharge and home care. When the babies are gaining weight till 2000 grams, in the sense, somebody raised hand. Sangareshwari, want to ask anything? See, I got a raise hand option from Sangareshwari. Any doubt? No? Yes? Okay. Then discharge and in home care, at least the babies has to gain 20 gram per day. If the baby is gaining 20 gram per day, in the sense, the baby can discharge. Then they have to attain at least 2000 grams, that is 2 kg. The baby is attaining 2 kg, in the sense, they can go for discharge. breastfeeding or cup feeding. The baby is taking breastfeeding well, otherwise the baby is taking cup feeding well, in the sense we can discharge. The mother is confident enough to take care of the baby. Now, sometimes the mother may not have the confidence enough, or they don't have anybody to take care of in the home, in the sense they can prolong the hospital stay. Otherwise, the mother is confident enough, they can discharge. Then good follow-up care is arranged. First, in the first week, they have to come for follow-up weekly, then monthly, then 6 months once. Like that, we can reduce the hospital visits if the baby is okay. Then follow-up, after going to the follow-up, regular follow-up is necessary after discharge also. Then the baby should be very close to the mother, as well as the mother should be very close to the professionals, as well, primary health center nurses or public health nurse, whoever it may be. Before the discharge of the patient, before the discharge of the mother and baby, the primary health nurse should go and visit the home, whether it's okay for the gangroo mother care, it's healthy to the baby and mother, like that, they should go for a home visit. Then they should decide that whether they can discharge or not. Then skilled professional should be needed. There's whatever doubts, they can immediately, they cannot go here and there for the hospitals, no? So their follow-up should be some connection with the professionals. Then in the beginning, they have to, frequent visit should be there. After that, the visit can be reduced according to the health of the baby. Then other mothers, if somebody else is already having the gangroo mother care, in the sense, that mother's help can be rendered to the mother's new mother. So it will give more confidence to the baby. Confidence to the mother for taking care of her baby. These are all the references. Thank you so much. That's all. Any doubts you have, in the sense, we can. Shall I stop sharing?